don't require this plethora of protein. So rather, I would argue that the complexity reflects the need for strict regulation and higher order communication functions of the plasma membrane. So key regulators of vesicle formation at each of these stages are members of the GCCA superfamily. The RAS-related GCCAs, SAR and R, regulate vesicle formation at the ER and the Golgi, respectively. And the main gist of this talk is to tell you about dynamin, which regulates vesicle formation at the plasma membrane. So dynamin is both the brains and the brawn plasma-mediated endocytosis, and that's one of the main take-home messages of this talk. It was first discovered, its role in endocytosis was first discovered in 1973, actually at my alma mater, the University of British Columbia, by David Suzuki, who was conducting temperature-sensitive screens for chemically-induced mutagenesis in flies. And he set up a screen for paralysis and isolated the Shibiri fly, which is Japanese for paralyzed, providing the first evidence for involvement of dynamin in endocytosis. Bing Dang at UC Austin made this movie for me. These are mutant flies and wild-type flies being subjected to ever-increasing temperature. And you can see, as the temperature gets above 30 degrees, the mutant flies drop like flies. Whereas the wild types are unaffected. This is a rapidly reversible phenotype. Jane Koenig and Kazuo Seda at the University of Hope in California studied these flies by looking for, not surprisingly, since they had this paralyzed phenotype, at the neuromuscular junction. And at the neuromuscular junctions of these flies, you can see at the non-permissive temperature, the typical morphology of a synapse, the neuromuscular synapse, chock full of synaptic vesicles and dark here at the muscle. Whereas just 5 minutes after shift to the non-permissive temperature, you can see the synaptic vesicles have been completely depleted, and instead you see this accumulation of endocytic profiles on the presynaptic membrane. At higher magnification, Kazuo Keita noticed that many of these endocytic structures have an electron band at their neck called the colored tip. Some years later, Shibiri was thrown by Richard Valley and Alex Vanderblake at the same time and discovered to be the homolog of a mammalian protein that Richard Valley had discovered and called dynamin. Dynamin is atypical GCCA. In addition to the standard RAS-related G domain, it has a middle domain, a Z domain that involves its self-assembly, a pH domain that interacts with targets to PI45P2-containing membranes, and a C-terminal proline arginine domain that interacts with several of these endocytic accessory proteins that are SH3 domain-containing molecules. Dynamin is a tetramer in solution, so if you think of RAS as small GDPases and trimeric G-alphas as large GDPases, you can think of this as the Arnold Schwarzenegger of GDPases, or not to mix metaphors, the Incredible Hulk of GDPases. It has a low affinity for GTP in the 10 micromolar range. The consequence of this is, unlike RAS-related GDPases and trimeric GDPases, it does not need a GEP to activate it. It does not need a guanine exchange factor to yank off bound GDP that is so tightly associated so that it can be loaded with GDP. Rather, in the cell at steady state, it will always be in the GDP bound form. It also has a robust basal rate of GDP hydrolysis of about 1 per minute. Dynamin self-assembles onto rings and spirals in low-salt solution or in the presence of GDP aluminum fluoride. This is for a discovery that Jenny Vinson made when she was in my lab at Scripps. And onto liposomes, either acidic or PIP2-containing liposomes, to form these long dynamic spirals, very reminiscent of the Shibiri collars seen in the Drosophila mutant. This self-assembly stimulates dynamic GTP protease activity about 100-fold, and mutations in the JED, the GTPase effector domain, impair self-assembly and decrease dynamic, influence dynamic GTPase activity. So it's based on Jenny's discovery that dynamics self-assembles into these polymer structures on its own, and previous work in my lab using the in vitro assay that Jennifer had referred to, where we had shown that you accumulate, you accumulate constricted coated pits in the presence of non-hydrolyzable analogs of GTP. Jenny and I proposed that dynamic function as a mechanochemical enzyme, that upon addition of, in the presence of GTP, dynamic would self-assemble into this collar-like structure at the neck of a deeply invaginated coated pit. And if dynamic underwent a coordinated GTP hydrolysis, these assembled subunits would undergo concerted conformation that together could generate the force necessary for scission. However, to test this model, we made mutations that were specifically defective in this self-assembly reaction and assembly-stimulated activity. This work by Sonia Sever in my lab. And unfortunately, when we put these mutants in vivo to look at their phenotype, we got exactly the opposite phenotype that our model would have predicted. That is, overexpression of these mutants that selectively impair self-assembly and therefore assembly-stimulated GTPase activity actually accelerates the So that led Sonia Sever and I to propose another model for dynamic, in which we proposed that dynamic was actually like every other GTPase in the world, not a mechanochemical enzyme, but indeed a regulatory enzyme. In this model, we suggested that dynamic must, in its GTP-bound form, interact with effector molecules that control the rate limiting step of vesicle formation, so that if we make mutations that are impaired in self-assembly and therefore in the gap activity, we would prolong the interaction of dynamic with these effector molecules and accelerate the rate limiting steps of vesicle formation. And that self-assembly and GTP hydrolysis, which activated the gap, in a sense, would, like other GTPases, serve to negatively regulate activity and turn off the molecules from the site. So these are apparently conflicting models, embarrassingly both suggested by me, but thankfully both published in Nature, so gave us lots of chance for reviews. But what I'd like to suggest is that, like this optical illusion of an older and a younger woman, that these two models for dynamic are not mutually exclusive. So we think now that dynamic plays a dual role in coated vesicle formation, that it functions early as a regulatory and this function is in its unassembled state, where it's targeted at early stages to Claflin-coated pits, and in this regulatory mode, it functions to regulate and monitor coated pit maturation and control these slow stages of vesicle formation, requiring basal GTP binding and hydrolysis activity. It subsequently, after self-assembly, switches to its second mode of operation as a component of the fission apparatus. These late stages of dynamic function, the fission reaction is very rapid compared to the maturation process, requires self-assembly and